Welcome to August 19th, the sixth work day of the week, preparation day for the Sabbath. For a few days now, we've been going about the Sabbath. Well, brethren, today we're going to continue in to some information about the Sabbath. I hope you all can set in and enjoy it. I suggest, brethren, you write the chapter and verses down so that you'll be able to go back and study the whole context at your own leisure. You can use a pause button down here in the corner, brethren, to start and stop this video study as you go along so you can find the proper place in your own Bible to be able to read along with this. Today's study is Jesus upheld the Sabbath, the seventh-day Sabbath I'm going to go into here. And if you want to know what day it is, some people would say they can run every seventh day, no matter if you pick out on a Wednesday and you can count seven, the seventh day would be the Sabbath. Other people say that the first day of the week, that you can count seven from there and you will get and be on the seventh day of the week or Sunday. But I tell you, the Bible tells you right where it is. Go to Genesis chapter 2, verses 2 and 3. And there in chapter 1, it enumerates each day. And in verses 2 and 3, he enumerates the seventh day for the rest and resting in them. Two verses, that Hebrew word is Sabbath, and that's where we get our Sabbath. It is the one that he sanctified, made holy, or set apart. Well, brethren, let's get right into Jesus upheld the Sabbath. Throughout his earthly ministry, Jesus observed the Sabbath. Luke records this in Luke chapter 4 and verse 16. And he came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up, and as his custom was, he went to the synagogue on the Sabbath day and stood up to read. On many occasions, Jesus incurred the wrath of the Pharisees because he did not live according to their man-made Sabbath regulations. They have over 1,000. I have a book telling about the thousands of regulations that the Pharisees put in that the Lord never intended to be there. He healed on the Sabbath. He allowed his disciples to shell out kernels of grain to eat. He told a man to pick up his bed, roll out, contrary to the Pharisees' traditions, but never once did he speak negatively about the Sabbath itself. On the contrary, he observed it and showed in a positive way how it should be kept. He proclaimed himself Lord of it. Go to Mark chapter 2, verses 27 through 28, and we will read. And he said unto them, the Sabbath was made for man, and not man for the Sabbath. Therefore the Son of Man is Lord even of the Sabbath. Jesus was indeed Lord of the Sabbath. He was there in the beginning, God, with God in creating it. John chapter 1 and verse 3. Ephesians chapter 3 and verse 9. Colossians chapter 1 and verse 16. Hebrews chapter 1 verses 1 through 2. He showed by his example how it was to be kept as a blessing for mankind, as the day of freedom and delight. He showed that doing good, taking care of animals, handling emergencies, shelling out grain to eat were all permissible on this day of rest. In Matthew chapter 12, verses 11 through 12. In Luke chapter 14 and verse 5. He had objected to the inhumane traditions of men that turned the Sabbath into a burden. He upheld the rest, the rejuvenation of freedom enjoyed by the fourth commandment, Mark chapter 3, verses 1 through 5, and in Luke chapter 13, verses 11 through 17. Even at the end of his ministry, a few days before he died to pay for the sins of the world, Jesus indicated that the Sabbath command would continue after he is dead, in prophesying the destruction that was to come on Jerusalem in A.D. 70. Jesus told his followers in Matthew chapter 24 and verse 20, "But you pray that your flight not be in the winter, neither on the Sabbath day." If the Sabbath command was to have been nullified by his death, Jesus' statement makes no sense at all. On the other hand, his statement indicates that the Sabbath would continue as a holy day for God's people. Hence, an emergency flight, while not strictly prohibited, would not be in the keeping with God's purpose for this day of rest. Throughout his ministry, Jesus affirmed the Sabbath to those who call him Savior and Lord need any other reason to keep it. Brethren, in God's word only do we trust, never in the tradition of men. Beware of the tradition of men that make void the word of God. Constantine, in the year 300, he changed the Sabbath day, the seventh day, into the first day. He says to stop Judaizing. The Sabbath is not Jewish. It is the Lord's day. You'll find that in chapter 20 of Exodus, the fourth commandment. It states that it is the seventh day. How do you know the seventh day? As I told you, go back to Genesis chapter 2, verses 2 and 3, and find what day that was. Brethren, if you want to follow the Lord, get down on your knees and repent for following the tradition of the men that is making void the Word of God. By making the void the Word of God, you will never see eternal salvation. I don't say that. Your Bible says that. And brethren, while you're on your knees, ask for the wisdom, the knowledge, and the understanding that is found in the letter he sent to you. And that letter is in your own Bible. Well, brethren, with that, we're going to close for today. You all have a great and wonderful day. I know I will. God willing, we'll see you tomorrow. Bye for now.